I ain't got the time nor the patience for strangers.
Move already.
Looking to sell your wares or buy some of the finest meat to ever grace this town? Come back when you're in the market for real quality.
Howdy to you.
I'll be right with you.
I know you're up there.
Oh, marvelous. There she is. Just what I need. The crazy wood nymph. Can't a man take a bath in peace?
What the hell is that?
It's a panther.
You savage.
And a nice clean one now, too. This is going above the mayor's bed. Okay, Mrs. Hobbs will be by to handle the taxidermy.
Oh, travel safe, my friend.
Wait, who are you? Where's Cecil?
Glenn. I'm a friend of his. Cecil had to take a few days off.
Mm-hmm.
For stress.
Is there any animal that you have not slaughtered?
Oh, you flatter me, Miss
Sorry,
Davenport.
Sorry, I really will be right
the
with you.
The answer's no, but I'm retired, as you know, and have been for some time.
Yes, and how many have you out there killing for you now?
Not nearly enough, I'm afraid. Business is booming. What about you there? You a hunter? Gus McMillan, master craftsman of fine clothing and accessories. Here's my card. I pay top dollar for animal furs and parts. The rarer, the better.
Don't listen to him. Unbelievable. How do you sleep at night?
On a tiger bedspread, my dear. Seriously, come see me.
You're no better than a murderer. And one day, you'll be seen as such.
Whoa. Would you mind taking us outside? I don't worry.
Shut up, Glenn.
Listen, soon as a squirrel finds a cure for tuberculosis, let's talk.
If intelligence is the barometer of who has the right to live or die, you should have been court-martialed at birth.
Annoying, isn't she? See him? The only thing he had on his mind was hunger, sweetheart. But I pulled the trigger. Survival of the fittest. Isn't that your mentor's trite catchphrase?
It's not survival of the fittest. You are killing to line your own pockets.
This is how I make my living. We don't all have a rich daddy. While you're camped out in the woods, making witches' brews and talking to the wildlife, the rest of us are doing some real work.
You think this is some big joke?
What the hell is that crazy
shrimp? They should throw you in an asylum.
That's it. I quit. You can tell the mayor I've gone home.
Oh, sorry about that awful man. Harriet Davenport. I've been in the field now for 3 years, studying the hidden interconnections between animals of all species. I've seen everything. I bet you joy, disgust, regrets, envy. We're so much more alike than we are different. I'm on the brink of discovering the pathways that link all life. I just need more research material. I have in here detailed notes on pretty much every animal from armadillo to Annisburg, including the locations of some truly impressive varieties. I would be willing to sell this to you if you will commit to bringing me anatomical samples from live species and promise not to carry out any more animal side in pursuit of Gus McMillan's greed. I'll pay you, of course. I promise I'm good for the money. Let's learn from nature, not destroy it. Come on. Excellent. Oh, we've been brought together for a reason. I strongly feel that. I've been experimenting with tonics that can provide access to remarkable new pathways of communication with other species. You have to live as they do, eat as they eat, hop as the toad, dig as the mole, love as the badger. If you see what I've seen, you just have to open your mind. Join me on a voyage of discovery.
Thank you.
right, my friend. You have come to the right place. So much good hunting in the hills around here. Almost makes me want to come out of retirement. I only use the best, I only sell the best. A wise purchase. You know what you like, don't you? And another? I'll need to make sure I keep this in supply. Hope to see you again.
What are you going to do about it, Sheriff?
About what?
My stolen property.
Well, ain't much I can do about it. I ain't got the manpower to go after Bob Crawfish. Howdy.
Howdo. I pay your goddamn wages, me and folks like me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Arnsdale. Really, I am. But there ain't nothing I can do about this. Not without more support and funding.
Will you go for me?
Wait, what?
Go. See if you can retrieve my lawful property from some goddamn thief.
Ain't nobody knows who took your stuff, mister.
I seem like some kind of liar. Is that why you won't help me?
No, but...
Listen, get me Bob Crawfish and his closest associates by any means necessary.
No, not by any means necessary. Kill nobody. Ain't nobody convicted of nothing.
I was robbed. Get them and bring them to me just down from Fort Riggs Station, and you will be handsomely paid. Sheriff.
Mr. Arnsdale.
Yo!
on time, you goddammit!
You're gonna get what's coming to you!
Untie me now!
Jesus.
We'll lose them on the river. Split up! Now! See you on the river! Hello, Clinton.
Hello, Clinton. How have you been since we robbed you? Where's my property?
I don't rightly know what you're talking about,
yes,
Clinton.
Yes, you do. My fine collection of Staffordshire china, gone. My paintings of scenes in Italy, gone. My collection of photographs of fairies, gone.
It's all just a big mistake.
Where are they?
We invested in them together. You owed us money.
I did no such thing. Where are my things?
In the basement of your sister's house.
My sister? Goddamn her to hell.
Here. Here's your money.
Kill these men, will you? In fact, don't kill them. Leave them on the tracks. Thieves!
Jesus and
Untie
Satan!
Untie me! Now, come on. Because of some Staffordshire china and an argument between a man and his sister.
Take your ropes off!
For a moment, I thought you were gonna let that train ride right over us. Look, I ain't gonna pretend I like you or what you done, but you wouldn't kill a man in cold blood just on Clinton Arnsdale's say-so, so maybe you ain't all bad after all. You got what you came here for, didn't you? We all square here? Okay, we're square then. Let's go then. Our quarrel's with Clinton, not them.
Head still rolling from the road.
this, my old horse.
What's it to be? Done. Deal.
Itching for trouble or what?
There you are. How'd you get on?
She got on just fine. You know she did. Well, I know she did. Yeah, See it in the sky, you smell it in the air. She ain't no saint, but she's a good one. A fine gal in a nasty world. An American, I guess. Yeah. Oh, the madam picked well. Horley, this gal will do more than Avenger. With any luck, she'll save us all.
Oh, there ain't no luck, Mr. Jones. It's just a man's heart, not much else.
Well, she's got a fine one, a good one. Send her to help the marshal. The whole damn place is going to shit. And we need more good souls to let us loons rant in peace and howl at the moon in safety.
Maybe.
Oh, but don't you and the madam kill the girl with vengeance, nor kill her inside with grief.
Like you said, she's no saint. But like I always say, if you need to earn some money and stay somewhat out of trouble, go see Marshal Davies. He's supposed to stop every bastard killing innocent folk.
Of course, it's the nature of the thing that some souls go bad, and bad souls, some of them go good. But the marshal will see you right on that. The world can always use more good souls, and finds it easier to birth the bad ones.